Hello, I'm Michael Slohr, Head of R&D here at RaceResult, and today I would like to show you how many active V2 transponders you can detect at the same time. Here I have one tray of 50 V2 transponders, and to demonstrate what our system can do, I have brought a little bit more. I have another tray of 50, so making 100, and another one, 150 transponders. Actually, I have another three trays, giving us a total of 300 transponders. So, to demonstrate how many transponders the system can detect at once, the first step is to show you our management box. The management box is normally used in your storage room or pre-event to check transponders, check whether the trays are full or if you have them in a bag, how many transponders are there in a bag. So there is a check mode, and the check mode just counts the transponders it sees over the loop. So if I go over this loop here, like that, you will see that we're getting 300 transponders by scanning once. So I cleared the box and I'm doing it again. Scanning over the transponders, and the box is showing me 300 detections. So you might ask yourself, why is this so? Why can we scan 300 transponders at the same time? Actually, the reason is that our transponders work a little bit differently. Our transponders transmit the data on 2.4 gigahertz, and that 2.4 gigahertz channel is bidirectional. This means that the transponder gets a message from the receiving timing system that it has been heard. So if the channel is full with a lot of transponders, the transponder will retry its transmission until it gets an acknowledgement from the timing system. This way, we can never lose a passing information. Another important thing is that the read range of the 2.4 GHz channel is not limited by the loop. Actually, we can receive a transponder within a 40 meter radius around the timing system. So even if it takes the transponder a little bit to transmit the data, it will be received anyway, even if not over the loop anymore. Another important thing to know is that in the transmission of the data, the transponder tells the timing system how long ago it was over the loop. So even if it takes half a second to transmit the data, the precision is not affected. So, to give you a real-life example, instead of the management box, here I have a active extension, which is connected to our timing system down here. And I have this contraption here, which actually assembles a loop with a switch in it. And what I can do is I can very briefly enable the loop with that, simulating all these 300 transponders crossing the loop at exactly the same time within a tenth of a second. If you do your math, you will find out that this is equal to about 40 kilometers per hour, and it shows what you could do. Of course, it is not a practical example because you will never have 300 transponders passing your loop at 40 kilometers per hour at exactly the same time. But of course, it gives you peace of mind that you know that the system could do that. So to explain that again, I have our active extension connected to one of our timing systems. I have this loop going around 300 transponders, and I have this little switch giving me the possibility to enable the loop for a very, very short time, simulating 300 transponders passing a finish line within a tenth of a second. So we'll just do that now. That's it. So I hope you like the performance. Of course, it's not a real world example because you will never have 300 transponders passing your finish line at exactly the same time, but of course it gives you peace of mind that you know that our system could handle it. Thanks for watching.